Hi, it's President Wilson again. I just wanted to come back and give you a couple of messages related to the virus and vaccines. We do have a committee here at Wayne State called the Restart Committee. It's been meeting ever since, early March, I guess. And meeting pretty regularly, either weekly or biweekly. And we discuss all manners of things related to restarting the campus. We had a meeting this past week and some interesting things came out of it, so I thought I would communicate that to you. First of all, someone asked whether or not they would be able to select which of the various vaccines they would be able to get. The answer to that is probably not, and you should just go ahead and take whichever one is offered to you. Then the question was, well, are they all messenger RNA vaccines? And again, the answer is not, but there's nothing really special about messenger RNA vaccines. I think there's been a lot of publicity about them recently because it's the newest of the vaccines. But, you know, vaccines all work pretty much in the same way. And that is that you have these things called spike proteins on the viruses. The spike proteins facilitates the entry of the virus into the host cell, and that initiates the process of sickness. The point of the vaccines is to mount antibodies to the spike protein, and the spike protein then cannot facilitate the entry of the virus into the host cell. Now, what the messenger RNA does is it goes into the host cell and it has a genetic code for the spike protein and instructs the cell to make spike proteins. And that, of course, then initiates the immunologic response. But there are other ways in which the immunologic response can be initiated. For example, you can have a whole virus that's been killed or attenuated, greatly weakened. That's what happens with polio. This weakened virus won't cause disease because it's so weak, but it has a spike protein on it. The antibodies are mounted toward the spike protein, and again, that initiates then the immunologic response. You can also have something called viral vectors. Usually adenovirus is used. Adenovirus is used for a common cold virus. So the adenovirus is modified so that it doesn't cause disease. And again, there are spike proteins on it and antibodies are mounted toward the spike proteins. And so that initiates the immunologic response. AstraZeneca and Johnson & Johnson uses that kind of mechanism. And then finally, you can have protein subunits. The spike protein is typically the protein subunit in which antibodies can be mounted to that. This kind of vaccine usually requires an adjuvant or something to help boost the immunologic response. But this is what happens with the flu vaccine. It's the mechanism used with the flu vaccine. And it's the mechanism used in one of the vaccines undergoing clinical trial now, the Nonovax vaccine. These vaccines all work in the same way in that they mount antibody response to the spike protein. The spike protein then, the antibodies, once they bind to the spike protein cannot facilitate the entry of the virus into the cell so that the disease process does not get started. So when the time comes, take whatever vaccine is available to you. And then the last thing I'll say about that is that, you know, they're all effective. You may find, different reports about different efficacy, but it's hard to interpret all of those because they're not head-to-head comparisons. The study design's different, two doses versus one dose. Some study populations had a lot of variants, some didn't. The bottom line is that they're all effective, and just take whichever one is available to you. The second question that was asked was related to what the fall is going to look like for students. First of all, I think you agree with me that we've been pretty conservative thus far, and we've tried to not say things that we have to walk back. But this is a difficult one to really know for sure. So I'm going to give you my best guess. And my best guess is that we'll be predominantly face-to-face. It's going to be modified, and that we'll still be social distancing. We probably won't have huge classrooms of 200, 300 people. We'll spread out more, things like that. But I think we'll be predominantly face-to-face. Why do I think that? Well, first of all, the number of cases and deaths have been going down precipitously, so that's good. I think also sometime in April, probably latter part of April, supply is going to outstrip the demand for the vaccine. So those who really want to get it, who currently are not on any of the priority lists, will start getting the vaccine. So that's good. Obviously, there's some headwinds. One headwind is the variants. So we got to get ahead of that. Another one is, the number of people who refuse to take it. But I'm feeling pretty, pretty good about the vaccine. I do think that, like I said, that we're going to have to continue to practice some safe practices, but for the most part, I believe that most of the classes, or many of the classes, will be face to face. So we'll see. I mean, it's hard to predict, but this is my best guess based on where we are right now and where I think things are going to be over the next several months. So take the vaccine when it becomes available to you, and I'll see you again soon. Warrior strong.